Chess is a really interesting game to study when it comes to artificial intelligence. It has a long history, and it's often the place people go to first when they want to try out a new artificial intelligence idea or technique, because it's such a well-defined game. Hi, my name is Siddhartha Sen, and I'm a principal researcher in Microsoft Research New York City. And today I'm going to talk about a research agenda that I've been developing and leading for a while, which I like to call hybrid algorithms. I spell it H-A-I-B-R-I-D because the H stands for human and the AI stands for artificial intelligence. And the goal of this project is to find the right synergy between human solutions and AI solutions in a variety of areas and domains. I'm studying data structures, algorithms, systems, a variety of topics. And the goal always is to see what is the right marriage between current human heuristics that we have and artificial intelligence. So one domain that has been particularly interesting for us to look at has been the game of chess. And chess is an age-old game played between two players, black pieces and white pieces. Many people know the game. Many people have been playing it since the pandemic hit around. And it's a game that AI researchers like to study because it's well-defined, it's simple, and yet it's not fully solved. So we had these heuristic-based engines, and recently we've had engines that use deep reinforcement learning that have outperformed the heuristic-based engines. And then recently the heuristic-based engines got better, so it's this constant competition between these engines. So one of the projects that I've been working a lot on recently is called Maia. And the goal of Maia is to try to understand the relationship between humans and AI in this game of chess. And now it's one thing to tell someone what that move is, it's another thing to explain to them why that's the move they should make. And it's not always clear that every person will understand that move because it's the best move. So what the Maia project does is it tries to develop an AI engine that can do a better job of understanding human play. Given a position on the board, we look at a human of a particular skill level and we ask the question, what move would they make? And the way we developed Maia was essentially by taking the deep reinforcement learning neural networks that are out there that have been currently used to predict moves and retraining them to instead try to predict what a human player would do. Predicting what a human is going to do is not easy. Most positions that people reach in a chess game are unique because there's so many possible positions that oftentimes when you look at a position, it may never have been reached before. Right? And on top of that, people have their own playing styles, and even the same player might not make the same move when you give the same position to them twice. And so despite all this, what we're able to do with Maia is we're able to take all this human game data, train this neural network to predict human moves, and show that it actually achieves really good accuracy. And it's not just the fact that it achieves good accuracy, it's that it is able to achieve a different kind of accuracy depending on the level of the games that we train on. So we have developed a widget online that is actually a part of a blog post that we have on the Microsoft Research blog, but it's also available on our Maia website where you can explore different board positions and look at what Maia at different skill levels would play in those positions and what an actual human played in those positions. So we trained a bunch of these different Maia engines and we can show that each Maia does a good job of predicting the moves played by players of that skill level in a shape that looks like this. So the performance peaks at that skill level, and then it gets worse as you go lower, and it gets worse as you go higher. That means when we train a Maia for 1,200 rated players, it's able to predict 1,200 rated player moves very well, but it doesn't do a good job of predicting moves that are played by players of lower rating. And when you create a bot that learns how to do that, the bot that you create might actually be stronger than 1,500. Why? Because you're not just learning from one individual 1,500 rated players' moves, you're learning from a collection of them, like a committee of them. So it's almost like you have a team of 1,500 rated players working together. It's almost like you have like group knowledge or the wisdom of the crowd, sometimes people call it, right? It's like you get a group of people together and they're collectively somehow stronger, more intelligent than any individual member of that group. So this is exactly the kind of performance we want, that we were hoping to get actually. Maia really is able to learn what humans of a certain skill level will do and achieve peak performance at that level and taper off on the lower end and on the higher end. So this was one of the first achievements we had with Maia, which we were pretty excited about. After that, we took Maia and we said, can we take this one step further and train it to learn an individual player's playing style? You can think of it as a teaching assistant for a class of people of that level, right? And when we try to personalize Maia, it's almost like trying to create a private coach assistant or a private teaching assistant, because now we're trying to not only focus on players of the skill level, we're trying to focus on a specific individual player. Maia is an open source project and we've put all our code up online. So in theory, any developer can use this code to train a neural network and train a Maia engine for a particular skill level or for a particular person if they have enough training data. And for us, training data means chess games that you've played online. We've open sourced our code, which includes the chess engines and bots that we've created and the neural network architecture and the code for training these neural networks so that you can create your own chess engines using publicly available chess data, whether it's a set of people games or if it's a particular individual games, whatever you would like. So this is available for developers to use and to build on. I think that there's a lot of potential in taking these ideas of creating an engine, creating a piece of AI that matches human decisions, and then trying to take that AI and fine tune it so that it can match the decisions of a particular individual that might apply to other domains as well. So we can use these personalized Maias to actually identify who played a game without even knowing who played that game, just by looking at the game itself. So this is a task we call stylometry. It's basically like trying to find the style of a player. Can you identify a player based on their style? So in this way, we can do stylometry, but for chess players. And so this is something that I'm particularly excited about because it means that it's taken our ability to match and learn human decisions from a skill level bucket down to an individual level. It's not that hard to create an engine that has the rough core skill level as a human, right? If you just look at the numbers, like how many games they win or what their rating is, it's pretty easy to come up with an engine that matches that. That doesn't mean that you've matched human behavior. It just means that you've got the same final end result. But how you got there, what decisions you made, what mistakes you made, what correct moves you made, all of that could be completely different from how a human would play. But with Maia, what we're looking at is move by move, decision by decision, are we making the move that the human player would have made? And the answer is yes. Our goal is for Maia to become an algorithmic teaching assistant for chess. And the two tasks we've achieved and completed so far, which are two small steps, but they're on the right path, are first to predict what moves a human will make in a given position, a human of a particular skill level, as well as a particular individual human. And the second thing is to recognize a human's playing style by just looking at their games. What we want to do now is to take this and try to unpack it a little bit, understand what's going on underneath the covers so that we can get a better idea of an individual player's strengths and weaknesses. Because our ultimate goal would be to actually help people improve their play. And this is something that requires a more of a social science type of study that we haven't done yet. So I'm really looking forward to doing that. The Maia bots are also currently active on lechess.org. You can play them and you can learn from them. And so if you're an avid chess enthusiast or a chess learner, you can actually improve your own game of your own gameplay by playing these bots. And so one of the goals we have in this project is to bridge that gap and make it more of a conversation, make it more synergistic, more productive for them to work together. And so to me, that's really the larger vision and dream, is to use chess to understand what the architecture of a good teacher is. What should a good teacher be able to do? And once we understand that, can we actually fill in parts of those pieces, parts of those components in this architecture of a good teacher with artificial intelligence, with AI engines? I don't think we can replace all of it, obviously. As I mentioned, I don't think we're ever going to replace human teachers, and I don't want to. And so I'm looking at education research and other fields that have studied and asked this question. And it's surprisingly hard to pin down what really makes a good teacher or what the building blocks of a good teacher are. Maybe because it's not, there are no hard and fast rules here. I hope you enjoyed that discussion of Maia and our new chess engine. If you're interested in learning more about Maia, a good place to go is our website, which is maiachess.com. And we have a lot of information there, including research papers, links to our GitHub repo where you can find source code, links to the chess engines and the chess bots that you can actually play online if you have an account on Lee Chess, and other things like that. So I hope you go to their website and check it out. And thanks again for listening.